Here we are at the Canadian Food and Wine Institute at Niagara College.
So today we are pouring for you guys the Tom Thompson Algonquin Red. This wine is a really, really neat wine because basically the project that inspired it was the art gallery of Tom Thompson decided to hold an event with winemakers, chefs, and essentially each chef and winemaker got paired up and they had to get assigned a painting that they had to recreate into a wine. So if you love food, art, and good wine, I mean, I'm sure that would have been a good time. Additionally, as we know, Tom Thompson really is kind of one of our Canadian treasures in terms of Canadian art and history. The story of Tom Thompson is a really neat one. Basically, it's kind of a spooky Canadian ghost story, and that's why I love this wine too, because you can take it over to your guests and kind of pour and tell them the story. You get a beautiful painting on the front, so you can kind of play on that as well. And this one is a blend of Merlot, Cab Sauv, and Cab Franc. And again, this is the crowd-pleasing wine. It's going to go great with really any Italian herbs and tomatoes. Whether you do margarita pizza, bruschetta, bolognese, bocconcini, and basil salad, it's all going to go delicious. And again, it's really just nice on its own. I totally forgot to mention that it loves chocolate. But again, this is really your go-to dinner party wine because it's going to be kind of something for everyone. And lastly, we're going to end with our spooky, scary ghost story. So Tom Thompson, basically his legacy ran from about, 1877 to about 1917. So basically, he was, again, a Canadian painter. He loved portaging, loved going on canoe trips, especially out to Algonquin Park. And basically, he would kind of go out, find his solace, find his inspiration, and create really, really beautiful works of art. Now, he went on a trip and basically just didn't come back one day. He had mysteriously vanished. And this was really interesting because they basically found the canoe, they found some of his paintings, but they never found him. Again, it's a very spooky story with really quite a tragic end. But of course, his legacy still lives on through the art that he has created and of course the wine that we create.
So is it possible Tom Thompson's out there somewhere?
You know what, it's funny, everybody's got their theories. I was talking to one woman one time, she said maybe he got sick of the fame, maybe he just went off the grid and now he lives in a cabin somewhere. And I like to think that because that's the more romantic thought for sure. Additionally, nobody really knows what happened just because the death of him is so, so mysterious. And it's kind of spooky because he did die mysteriously, well, at Canoe Lake, basically. And this wine, again, was kind of to commemorate the 50th anniversary of Tom and his legacy.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Thanks, Rachel.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for coming.
Cheers.
Cheers.